Hello and welcome. My name is Brian Shin and I play the sousaphone in the Dixieland Jazz Band. And I like to share what I do as a bass player. Before I play, I look at the chord changes of the music and then see how they relate together. And then I try to figure out different directions I can take. But let's talk about very basic stuff for now. I brought you here this tune. This is called Now's the Time. In the key of F, and let me just play a couple of times and let's talk about what I do. Okay, let's talk about what I just did. Alright, let's look at the music. See, I played only the roots and the fifth until second chorus. And then I started to add some extra notes from third chorus to the end. On the first and second chorus, I didn't play the same notes over again and again. Well, I should say I didn't stay in the same positions. What I did was I try to play in different octaves overall so that I can give the band different color and dynamics. From the third chorus, I played some half step of the chords, and this is called half step approach. I use this a lot. Most of the time I play half step below the next chord. Well, of course I can also play half step above the next chord. With playing like this, I can push the band forward. Okay, this time I will play four more choruses with different ideas. Here we go. Let's talk about what I did. Okay, I'm looking at the music. Okay, on the first chorus, when I moved from 4th to 5th major, I played some scales. On the 4th major, I played F, G, A flat, and A. And here the note A is the half step approach of the B flat, which is the next major, next chord, right? But also this is bebop scale of the B-flat 7. And on the 8th major, we have D7, which is secondary dominant. I played chord tones basically of this chord because I really wanted to point out different color. Let's see. On the fourth major of the second chorus, I played basically F Mixolydian scale. And C B flat 7 is the target chord, and we have only 4 beats to get there. So then I need to figure out how I can use the distance. And the same, the third and the fourth chorus, I use pretty much the same ideas. Okay, so this is very basic ideas that I use. I don't play like this all the time, but I usually start play like this. Maybe first, second or third courses, I start with this, and then I try to put some more, add some more notes, and then I can give the band more dynamics with many different ideas. And it really depends on how the band goes. Improviser, you know, such as a trumpet player, or you know, piano or saxophone players. It really depends on how they play. So, see if you are a classical tuba player and trying to learn some jazz music. This is one way to do. Of course, there are many, many different ways to learn. And today I talked about two things. First, play the root and the fifth. And the second, play some extra notes such as half step approach or chord scales. Well, in terms of chord scales, we need to talk about more theory stuff, but we'll get into that later. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. And please share with your friends. And see you next time.